Hello, first, now good evening. The program in the watch now, Lota, the issue from Independent Television, Edo State, Nigeria. And of course, you know, every Monday like this, and of course, every Friday, we always adjourn all the time to discuss issue and get to do with this country, this state, and Nigeria. And that one they do all the time. From 9 p.m. to 10 p.m., we do on our Go TV and our Star Time. And of course, on our terrestrial station from 4:30 to 5:30 every Thursday with the always show done for Independent Television or terrestrial station. Today again, we don't come. Of course, we also discuss the issue of Nigeria. And this program today, now your program, we just specially designed this packet to be able to all hear from you too, wherever you watch us from. And most of the things we see, you don't also observe concerning the different reports we get from all the security challenges for this country. Would like to hear from you. So our phone number is 052-290-573. We'd like to hear from you in any part of Nigeria one day. We also hear from our brothers from San Francisco State, the one from Sokoto, the one from Yobe, the one from, Yobe and then Zamfara and all the Taraba, all of them would like to hear from them and how the other side be. But today, we don't come. My name is Emma Kololo. My brother from Safari and Joe for us, and I only two of us. Now good day today because we want to hear from my brother. Good evening, sir.
My people, if you say take time to don't support us well for this program, we salute you all the time. We so that don't take the day again. Like when I know every Monday we deal with you by nine to ten. Now we take the on ground for inside this program. I may not still forget to say on Friday too, we see the with you now. And on our terrestrial transmission by 4:30 every Thursday. With the ongoing, we really there to really see what we go fit do to develop our country, Nigeria. Other people they move. What we go do to follow to make sure say generation to come, they will still benefit from things we be so we don't put for granted. We go make this country move forward. And they always the tell person say, anytime like this will come, does that mean say any good thing not they happen for Nigeria again? If they happen, no. Just like come be like say the good news. You know the waka compared to when you vote news day, like when they talk for Bible when they say, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Jesus, yeah. I can say, come and see yourself. So when we they discuss like, we still know say good things they happen for Nigeria, but which we will really do to make sure say this good thing day forward, because what will they always they see you come out for years when our brother Andrew. I think that one around the 70 something when you say you want to check out of Nigeria.
Andrew, not check out.
So when we come sit down now, we look that time when Andrew say you want to check out, and we can't look this time. If we say we'll go back to Andrew time, and we say we'll look at this time, but we will say Andrew time good now, Abby, and at this time, come go back. Many now they talk, say, hey, Andrew never even see. Then he say you want to check out that time. So if you see the one who did so, you go not say, hey, that time. Nah, everyone I would do. So why would they ever say how will fit they live like this as a country? We get all the resources, we get everything we'll be so we'll fit the enjoy. Which one do we go fit do to make sure say this country is good? We they here for and I you today therefore. So this one among the things we say we are with the share for inside this program. And why we see the Mapololo, not forget the ministerial
screening,
the
screening yes.
See they go on. Yeah, now as everybody too, they join our president. We too, they join our. We say Edo and give two slots.
Two slots to adjust here, because of course now I do they transmit to the world. So we no go ever say we no go talk about her. And I've two very prominent sons of Edo. Now they pick as ministerial nominee, or rather now one they don't scream. And a very good news. Of course, one very profound physician. When Mr. President himself say no, this doctor, and they bring her, then of course the another very intelligent, another very intelligent, and also too. When we see in the words of, I think Senator Odia say one fine Edo product, maybe person of the matter. We congratulate them, say they go through the screening, and then we see they go make Edo State proud, and then also the again to thank our Monoba, they don't quite for the at least. Within the ask Mr. President, Mr. President now. Effie, when you look, we will just start from the basis. When you look at our police today, people always complain about police. To you, when you see within the state they work, when police, within the state they work, the package, when they get injury, when they get, you believe say government actually they do it for this sector of the economy or under these people.
I think the only thing I'll first talk is say I not really they see the paper where they take the approved money give them. Maybe when federal government bring their own record, the police as a management bring their own record. This one I waiting will never really see. Police never share all their record where they take care of them, their management. And the federal government may see how much they don't really they give them every year when they bring up budget. If not, if I say me, I talk with what they see for high, for street, or when I go any division, I think I'll talk say they never really take care of the Nigeria police well. But why I put the bet, I never see paper when federal government go talk say, how you go talk say, we never really take care of the police. Well, when we say this year, see how much we vote for police, make them tell us what they use and do.
Okay, but compared to other security agencies, where police die, where even for their barracks, you believe say those areas too? I agree.
No, let me put the talk now. Let me put when I did talk, I come put down for one edge, say police management, because the same federal government who they talk about, now they take care of police, now they take care of SSS, now they take care of army, now they take care of immigration, now they take care of civil defense, now they take care of road safety, now they take care of prison, air force, fast. Now the same federal government. So why police case can't be like this? Now it can be the clause when we say I never to understand. Because if the same federal government they take care of all this agency, things different compared to police or what they talk about. So what can they ask? What they talk now say now the management of police, now this fourth day in hand now or now federal government. Now that area now never too clear. As that person will say the ultimate prepare for yeah. So that place never too clear. Because ordinarily, as I talk, if I see me, I see with Twitter, they see for street, see them for police station, see them after retirement, see them after death. May I use that one, George? I'll say this country, Nigeria, never really differ to the police.
One of our sisters, blessing his sister, a brother with the police conduct. As he died, they go there. After everything, every answer so many signal. Then they said with the money they approved for the burial, now 100,000. And they cause making joke, I can't remember, say, after 2 years, now he to get the money. So all this kind of thing now, if they try to become with it, is if you discover now for this country now, that they do recruitment recently, it security challenges could be one place when you see now just gonna have a prominent thing right now because you do almost every part of this country. But the encouragement and what we book also they call those things where they make people the what ginger them to do, you know they.
If you know they now they tell you just now say if you know they know who will want blame. Because if you see many people, they always they complain for the system now, and mostly this rank and file. And they always they complain. So when you see this complaint, they come from the rank and file. Is it that, say, the management, when you say, when this money enter police and the management, they chop the money? Let me, when I talk small, I'll talk about management. When I talk small, I'll talk about management. I say the management of the money, they reach this boy's hand. And this because they make this boy's hand, they complain. You understand me? Yeah. So all these ones now, they look, if not, for many countries when I don't travel, go, if I see the police for that side and I see police for Nigeria, I'll say we never really defer to the Nigeria police force because the force of among them, who they will talk to at this thing, the man where you send message to go kill armed robbers or cash armed robber or protect life and property, you know, say na risk. Ain't carry gun. The man when anyone go follow a fight, carry gun. Carry all dangerous weapon. At this stage, we'll talk, say, we never get hospital where federal government say they don't provide now. Say any police will be say sustained injury. Now once they'll take care and go there and they'll treat her free. We never see get her. And you expect people like that to go fight crime? I don't want to fight her. You never get her and I say any policeman will be say along the line, say he sustained injury or even die during the process. See better intensive money. Or with the package when he basically this person go get during that process, we don't get them. And when this one's not there, and the man don't say na risk nine they go for. Say this job when they go so now 50-50. That's where they push on, but now 50-50 now. Eda in Kaji, Amroba or the Amroba Kaji. Let me say it. So if along the line, the man when they do this kind of work, assurance never there for his future. They say, look us away for me, not be the building. Now the wife and children when you say they inside the house, then they say maybe they look for. If say okay, this process now something can happen, say we not pray for bad. This man die. In your picking, in wife, who want to take care of them? Children with their school, who want to give them scholarship? If a wife, how they want to take care of them to make sure say that family they survive for life. If at the end it's not really there like that, or who they take care of, the thing will come get as to be. When you call the man, the gentleman not saying no go go. He go tell
you
to go there.
Okay, make we join our people for Taraba State now. Maybe we just also see how Taraba State did this evening and the security situation. Hello, good evening, my brother.
What do we know?
People want to know your name and your office.
Okay, my name is Balada Nabo. I may be senior special assistant of media and publicity to the governor of Taraba State.
Okay, no, from the last time when we talked to you, now you don't tell well. And I would like to hear from you some of the things. Let me say you don't do for Taraba, because with the year of different killing and all of those things, how is the situation right now?
Well, the situation in Taraba State as of now is calm. There are no more incidents of crisis, killings, or whatever, at least in the past few weeks. But about some time ago, we had some incidents of crisis in the Benue Taraba border involving Gif and Jukun people. But the governor promptly intervened. Two times he sent his deputy to go and meet with the deputy governor of Benue State. In the past 3 weeks, they don't meet up to two times now. They were able to discuss the matter. They bring all the people who are prominent for both sides. Bring them together, and they ironed out their differences. Everybody complained about the thing where they caused wahala, and they tried to settle them. For now, there is peace.
Okay, nobody, but if we ask you now, what thing be the thing where they cause this wahala, we know they be finished?
So, the thing don't pay. This crisis don't pay. It been there since 1990. Nobody say it start during the time of Governor Eshaku or Governor Samuel Autumn of Benue. No, it been there for long. I think the problem is that the Yukun people and Tiu people were there for border. The population of that of the people where they for border there, it don't grow fast. And as they grow fast now, the land where they are available, they don't become, you know, they grow. You know, say land, you know, they grow. So as you know, they grow, people where they farm, they don't have plenty. So farmland don't they scarce. So if you go touch somebody's land, now wahala you find. So part of the problem where they cause the wahala na land. Everybody want land to farm because the people for that area na farmers them be. So that is the major cause of the crisis. Okay. But of course, some people like politicians, then they put hand, you know, then they put hand so that the thing, they put fire so that the thing can continue to happen. But things are normalizing now. I believe it will not happen again soon.
What about this issue of farmers and herdsmen, the killing here, killing there, coming to take in the night and all of those? So how far?
Well, that one too don't subside small. But it happened very seriously in the past. In the past 3, 4, 5 months ago, and even since last year, it has been happening. But in the past 2 months or so, it don't subside small. Except the one where happened near Jalingo, in the place where they call Kona. And then in other places in Ardukola local government. So these are the areas where the thing happened recently. But again, Oga Governor Darius Ishaku invited security people to assist. And for now, they don't stop. But we still have a curfew in force in those areas. As at now, by 9 p.m., there will be no movement in those areas, including Jalingo City. And but people like the people where they ride Keke Marwa, they take advantage of people in the night. So they too, they cannot move again as from 8 p.m. So all these measures where Oga Governor Darius Ishaku has taken has helped a lot to contain the crisis. So as of now, there is no more fighting, no more killing, and no more kidnapping, at least for the past 2 months.
So if we don't, they say
it don't go down small.
And when we say it don't they go down, why we be saying that coffee sit in some area?
Well, the coffee is still there, because once in a while you get to hear, say, then they come, and people will be scared. So security people don't want to confuse our own people with the people where they won't come attack. So now we say, that is why we say, make everybody they go inside. Nine, make you know, come on, day for your house. And if the security people see anybody outside at that time, especially in area where in the attack, then we know say na enemy. So it makes it easier for security people to check and maintain security, safety of lives and property.
As soon as we did sure,
say, no more threat, then go lift the curfew.
To you, as somebody will say, at least now don't spend the last 4 years, go enter another 4 years.
Yes.
Who by the people they really do this killing? Now those herdsmen, I be anything they will say, we know they see.
Everything that we see points to herdsmen. The herdsmen, now then they. Now then they come with arms and ammunition to come and attack. Then they kidnap. So, and most of the, now then they go to villages to attack people at night, to kill them and burn their houses. Everywhere, now then they do. Even outside Taraba State, now then they do. In Taraba State, now then they do. So the S-men, now then they cause all this wahala. No other person.
Okay, there are some of those villages when we say people for rock come on, they don't return back now.
For some places, it's not safe for them to go back yet. Sorry?
If you say it's not safe for them to go, which means the problem is still there.
And the thing they say, as they run come out, and they feel, then they hear rumor, so say, then they come, as I tell you before. So if they, for that kind of thing, it's not good to go and put your life into danger now. So it's not as if then they attack them now, but make life they safe. That's why they never return. So some of those people still there for IDP camps where government is taking care of them. Until we sure say, everything don't calm down, you know. So there's still fear. Even though no more no more attacks in the past few weeks. Fear is still there. Fear is still there. That's why, for fear, they are still staying in IDP camps until we are sure. Say the thing don't finish. You know, because the experience in the past is our best teacher. You know, if you know, in the past where they hurry go back, then come attack them again. So, and even the security people that we see around, sometimes you are not sure whether the people who are in uniform, whether they are genuine soldiers or they are fake soldiers, whether they are genuine police or fake police. Because this uniform for army, it don't reach many people's hands. So you don't know who be government soldier or where or the people where be herdsmen soldier. So that is why fear day. That's why people know they go back for now.
But so another question where they come, they ask. Aside the say what do they say SMA, they say robbers no cuckoo did the state or some of this the country before. When be say any attack do happen now, they just say SMA. Whether robbers not there for some of this state before.
Robbers na things and the na money or other materials and then they collect now. But S-men, they don't collect anything. Now to kill and go. Most of the time they don't carry, they don't carry anything. They come, attack people, kill them, burn houses, and then go away. But the robber not the quick kill now. Unless you say you surrender your property. The mode of operation for the two is different. So you can tell whether a robber or na herdsman. So there is no you cannot confuse the two. Even kidnappers, they are herdsmen. You know, kidnappers, they are herdsmen. The people here are not kidnapping. Now herdsmen, they do kidnapping, collect money. So all those things that them they do. There's nobody is confused about it. We know who behind all of these things. Now herdsmen.
Well, we salute you, the town with a general from Taraba this evening.
Thank you. God bless you.
Greet our governor for us. So.
He go here.
Thank you.
All right, FAUCM, the two things we did now, when you look at, if you see what you talk now, you say the, first of all, you say attack don't small.
Don't come down, but they never but return back.
If they never return back, let me say the thing today.
And so what you say coffee still there?
If coffee is there, let me say the attack never finish. So where do we go from here?
When I be say the place never say because it tell say and see the bad side of it again when it they touch us. They say army uniform full everywhere.
Yes.
Police uniform full everywhere. Mm-hmm. That you don't even know the genuine one, you don't even know the fake one. That if you even see army, there you go the fear. When you see police, there you go the fear because you don't know the genuine. So may you see the way the system can be. That you don't even feel identify. Not the way we say the security agent go feel put to identify them. I mean, don't they pour us now that even among themselves, they don't feel can't know what it is, they identify themselves. Me civilian, not just the fear. Because that this kind of thing, that if you go for victim, they go see the genuine police or genuine soldier. Either the one who grant or the one wrong.
Okay.
No, say that the genuine one now can say, for where we did, now you want to try out this one. So, wait, is be like this. Be like, say, now, system of failure.
All right. Like I talk, our phone number is 0522905733. We just look at the general security situation. I would like to hear from you too. Maybe you also just call in, let us know from your own end anywhere you call from. Because the other day, police can go at least assist the public, those state government.
Put on boy, make the public, make them know where we dey. Inside last week, police come talk to roadmaker. Now he be the thing. Now police come talk to roadmaker inside last week. Inside last 2 weeks, the DPO for Ekiadolo police station, the area commander, now he first started the road work. First turn to roadmaker. The DPO, the area commander, can go to beg nearby communities. Me all of them come out to go and go declare the express. before the state government inside last week come bring bulldozers and Akonte they clear with the police patrol now. The commission of police come now join among the road maker now. Where we say they go they clear the road. Like what and they always talk for where system they work. We need to help monsieur say the armed robber now don't they take life, they destroy property, they kidnap people before we come now say express is supposed to open and expand down. Common sense not tell us say express we don't supposed to allow grass come take over, say the place you don't go even they see bush to expand down. Say where you they go, make them they see say the bush clear. We supposed to cover wait like this. Go call the city police, go call lead everybody, carry bulldozers and carry the community, go the clear express. That will be system failure. We get federal ministry of work, we get the state works department, we get local government. This one now, when they break like this, men go go mad with their equipment like this, they go declare the bush. Without they not even wait, make police. Fair come wait now to come go declare the bush. Supposed to wait to this level. Now this one be waiting the investment for the country. But if time now election matter now, say time don't reach for election, they go no waiting they're supposed to do. Nobody they give the directive to take on election. Nobody they give the directive to go buy different type of vehicle where go they follow bush they go for campaign. They go share, you know the same motor. You know the same motor where we say they buy for campaign.
Yes.
Who they tell them to spend that money to buy a vehicle for campaign? Who they tell them to reach those interior villages for campaign?
Nobody.
Now we they share the tell them here. How come they get this sense for election and they know they get sense for they know they get this sense now for development? The police now need to go express carry bulldozers and go the clear road for where we get works for the three arm of government. But then when I see things like this, now they go down, they call, they'll still go they show up for television, show up for a talk up for radio, say they don't go the clear bush, they don't
Hello.
Go the clear bush, they go go the clear. As if say
Hello?
People they go by us.
Okay, look, we just approve for Zafara this evening. We will see check with you for that time. Now, good evening, you know.
Good evening, Mr. Emmanuel. How are you?
We are very fine,
well done.
How's Zamfara?
Zamfara is fine today. We had a very beautiful rainfall, and the whole place is so cool, and we are so fine.
I hope as rain they fall, so racial problem, not this Zamfara.
No. Problems are easing out of Zamfara gradually.
Okay, so first of all, you don't want to do that for independent television. Those things in Nigeria on the GoTV channel 107. So people would like to know your name and your office.
Okay, my name is Zelani Bapa.
Okay.
And I'm the senior special assistant to the governor on public enlightenment, media and communication.
Okay. So far from what you tell us last week till now, in terms of this security, the bandits and all, what has happened from that time till now? What do you think? If you tell us.
Okay. If you remember the last time I told you the peace accord is going on well. Okay. Up to that time, there was no additional abduction by any of the bandits, which is the situation up to date now. There was no abduction since that time for more than a month now.
Okay.
This is part of the peace accord. And secondly, part of the peace accord is for them to release the captives in their hands. You can only estimate, you don't know how many they are there with them, because there are different groups of bandits and many, many people have been abducted. But so far, more than 300 people have been released unconditionally without ransom by the bandits, which has never been recorded in the past. And this is to show you that the bandits are ready to go with the peace process. They have released over 300 without a ransom of one kobo. Sadly, there is this peace that is now taking place all over, so much so that all the markets that were not being patronized on their market day have now reopened, especially the notorious market of Shinkafi, where the people are always being killed.
But did you say sadly?
Sorry?
You say sadly, Abi?
No, so not sadly.
Okay.
I said the notorious market of Shinkapi. I am giving an example.
Yes,
but happily, not sadly, that all the markets have now been reopened. So there is virtually no market that is not taking place in Zamfara State today throughout the 14 local governments. And significantly, out of these 300 people released, there are 10 foreign nationals, that is Nigerian people who are not Nigerians. They are from Niger. They came from Maradi to buy things and sell things, and they were abducted by the bandits. 10 of them, they were all personally released to the Serkin Zamfara Anka. Serkin Zamfara Zurmi from the bandits, which were handed over by the traditional ruler to the police commissioner, and he brought them here. And again, the state governor has decided to create something like an IDP camp, where all these 300 people are being taken care of before they are handed over to their families. He said he cannot hand them over the way he saw them. They are being attended by doctors, and their health condition is being ascertained. They are being treated of their sicknesses, and they are being fed well. They have been given new clothes, and instead the doctors have to certify them well before they are handed over to their various families. And right now he has just returned from Abuja today, where he went to meet the army chief and the air force chief and the inspector general of police to cooperate with this government in terms of the security peace process he is pursuing. So because part of the demands of the bandits is that if the military continue to attack them, the peace process may not continue. So the military will be around, they will be patronizing, but there will be no fire exchange between them, so much so that until all the abductees are released. When they finish releasing the abductees, they agree that if they are not being attacked, disarmament is going to be the next. So probably by next week, if we are able to see the end of the release, they will start to disarm. And as I have told you earlier, the agreement by the governor and the bandits that when they disarm, they are going to be taken care of in terms of resettlement. Land is provided for them already, 100 hectares of land in each of the three senatorial districts, and the governor is going to build schools there, clinics there, veterinary clinics there, and all the facilities required. And if the settlers want a leader, they will also have a community leader there. So I think all the peace process is working very well, despite the fact that so many people are skeptical about it, but we are seeing the positive results.
But over here, people, they say the bandits and all those people, they do that, they are used to collecting big money. Will they, them now, the fear now be say, what is government going to do now, since these guys are used to be collecting big money? Will they not pose a problem later? Will they be able to come down to live in normal society, in normal life?
You see, the thing people don't understand is some of them have even said the money is worthless to them. When they are being paid this ransom, they are always in the bush. Even the food they will put in their mouth, it has to be smuggled to them, so difficult, they are not even enjoying the money. Some of them have been there in the bush for over 10 years, and they cannot even come out and see the city and enjoy the money. And they are even saying it themselves, that the money is now being useless to them. All they want is now to come into the town and villages and live like normal people. If they are Fulani, they rear their cattle, they continue to eat what they want, they continue to spend the money, the time with other people, because in the bush they cannot even have a house. They live underground, they dig holes because they are being bombed. So you see, they are not enjoying the money at all. They have realized over the 10 years that the money itself is not anything useful to them. The money has to be useful when you are living in a normal society. So their aim is now to come and live with the normal society. So I don't think the issue of money is now very important, because if it is important, they will not release up to 300 people without the ransom being paid.
Okay, but what was the reason for this banditry? Why were they doing all the way? What was the reason for it? Was there any agitation? Were they fighting for something? What to make them do? What did they do?
You know, actually, this thing started like a curtain rustling, you know. Curtain rustling, you know, is about stealing the cattle of others from them, and you go and sell them and continue to rear them as your own. But as it continued, you know, there was this problem between, because most of the bandits, sorry to say, are mostly Fulani. And the non-Fulani people continue to attack the Fulani. That is what actually happened. And it escalated. It became like a war between the NSAKAI, that is the vigilante, or the volunteers, let me put it this way, those who feel at that time, during the past administration, that the government is not protecting them, so they need to protect themselves. So they continue to attack others who they think are related to the group of the bandits. And it happens to be so. So the bandits escalated their own attack. And as it continued like that, you know, one thing leads to another. So the issue of abducting people to ask for money come in. And when the money was coming in, it became like a lucrative business. But at the end of the day, they are now realizing that after 10 years, that all this money they are collecting from people is not even useful to them. So what they want is to come and live with people together. And that is more important than being in the society. It's more important than to hide stock of money in the bush, which is not useful to you. And you can't take it to the bank. You cannot buy anything you want with it. In fact, you cannot even live in the bush easily, because you just have to dig ground to hide yourself, because the military are there patronizing all the time and with their firepower.
Okay, but the one way it surprised me most when they talk just now, say so far they don't release more than 300 people. Where do they keep those 300 people when they not see them?
They keep them where they are, inside, either inside the hole where they dig, or in the thick of the forest, because you know, in the unfortunate thing is, from Katsina down to Zamfara State, down to Sokoto State, there is no state that has the thickest forest, which you call the Dajerugu. There is the thickest forest in this zone, and that is the area where the bandits mostly live. So above, even the military may not be able to be spotting them very well. So that is where they keep them, or sometimes in bushes, they put them inside the hall.
Okay.
One thing I've forgotten to inform you also is that all the major roads that were not being followed today have been reopened, especially the most important one from leading to Jibia Katsina. It is now reopened and people are applying that.
Okay, the question where Wakwe asked before you go now, the time where they do those bush, no matter how the bush thick reach, helicopter not they fly those areas at that time?
It does. You know, the problem is there are so many technical problems which people have to understand. When you are hunting for somebody, he knows he is being hunted. So the military were recording so much. That is one of the press releases I gave by the instruction of His Excellency, that we have to be reporting the successes of the military, because that will what will boost their morale and dampen the morale of the insurgents. But when you continue to talk about the attacks of the insurgents and we keep quiet about the successes of our security forces, it is dampening the morale of our security. It is dampening the morale of the people who are being protected. They feel unsafe, and the bandits continue to get high morale. But I'm telling you, even recently the military made this press conference just before the peace process started. They have killed 54 of them, and they have arrested many of them. They have rescued so many, but it's costing more and more and more lives. So it's not, the peace process is here to stop killing people, just because you want to rescue others. It is to rescue everybody. That is the essence of the peace process.
All right, we salute you. Take join us this evening from Zamfara State.
Oh, thank you very much, Mr. Emmanuel.
So, is the road safe for us to come there now?
You are very safe, Mr. Emmanuel. we are living here very well, no problem.
So, may you greet
our governor for us.
Okay, thank you very much. You're welcome.
One of these days, we'll come greet and well for that side.
Thank you very much. You're welcome.
All right. Thank you.
You see the report from Zamfara.
Yes.
Say more than 300 people did their custody. Way be say they don't release them. They inside bush.
Yes.
You see the bush thick where. So because of that one, say they not fit go there to go release those 15.
That kind of thing.
More than 300 people.
Now they don't. Still there though.
More than 300.
Where did they keep them? He said it for the thick where.
Nigeria. More than 300.
When they don't release.
Not be community. Now community be that now.
Yes, sir. But another area when you talk when I like the issue of the reportage of the positive side of this our armed forces. Most of the time to
see no be all those things who they try to cover when they say the report source who of the media. Not ready to record sources of what the army they do. Not be if the person you open up of what in your operation, now you go talk. When the person you don't know about in your operation, what do you want to do? Not be when the thing go call the ad, now you consider the consider, not only the what it goes, Babadon, not just the report, but not the report, the big one. When they do anything, they go either. When they do anything, they go either. Public no go know. Nobody go know what that they do. Even when it is go, if the one even interview some PRO, he go fair wait, I never get clearance. And then Oga never tell me I talk. This one never tell me I talk. You know those packaging things? The one called do a packaging. When you do and say, the citizens get right to know what they go on for their domain. Anytime anybody go feed your entire PRO question, if the commander or the CP or the IG don't get chance, the PRO office, he open to citizen 24 hours. The media, the PRO office open to anytime you enter PRO office. I remember those days when if you say this work, this issue of tighty information never reached like PRO office be like our office too now. Anytime you enter PRO office, PRO, see what is it they go on, we go, so yeah, may we talk, on your camera, may we talk. But you remember, I said today, the PRO office, who they see today, na packaging on. They know what we open up, go say never get clearance, the guy never see me talk. Then, if you start to live like that, what do you expect the people to talk? Let me say, get what you the eye. If not, see you see journalists, see you see the media. You say you know talk here too, they never clear you to talk. Then the other side, what they see, what did they go do? The reporter. So now what did happen? When you see, say, the issue of say they don't report the sources, not the report systems, maybe this one too.
Anyway, but it's okay. It is very sad. See, the whole country now, when you go there, security is challenging. You go there, security challenge. But mostly,
we'll say go Sokoto just now. We really know. We know how Sokoto be. Whether at least by now, we expect say we don't get that news from there.
Hello.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
You there on to Udota for Independent Television for Edo State, Nigeria.
Okay.
Yes, who would like to know your name and your officer?
My name is Abu Shekara, and I be the DG Media and Public Affairs to Governor of Sokoto State.
Okay, so far, Sokoto State are one very peaceful state. Well, the last report of killing, oh, yeah, we can't be surprised. What did happen on that side?
And I don't say we did hear Zamfara now.
Okay.
I don't say Zamfara get that problem now. The problem, too much for Zamfara, and they kill people, then they kidnap people for Zamfara.
Okay.
I know say Sokoto and Zamfara get the same forest now. Now the same forest where they run from Zamfara, Sokoto, even reach Kaduna self. So all these bandits and kidnappers, now for that forest in the hide now, and now from that forest in the carry out attack. And the time when federal government move troops, go Zamfara, they fight bandits and kidnappers. Many of them come the run, come Sokoto side now. where the operations not very strong. So that's the problem for Sokoto. Na spillover where they come from Zamfara State.
Would they hear you go?
Yeah, so I say na spillover now.
Okay, so over and how na doctor the tackle land? How they na cut the tackle land there now?
Oh, come on, but progress don't we don't they make progress though, because even in Zamfara State then they do dialogue now, and they talk with bandits.
Yeah.
So they hear for news say people then they release people now.
Where?
So far now in Zamfara State, 300 people don't they released.
We don't talk to Bapa just over with the.
Yeah, hey, now so for Sokoto to then they release our victims now.
Okay, which approach now they use for that side?
Now dialogue too. Now dialogue with the approach dialogue. Now dialogue approach.
That's what we always have how they apply.
It yeah now the same thing now the same strategy now. Because the two governors been the hold meeting regularly now. With this new government, will come for Zamfara now.
Yes.
Corporations deal between Sokoto and Zamfara.
Okay.
And then they talk to bandits, and we they talk to bandits too. And we they realize the effect. We they make achievement there because bandits they down their guns, they turn new leaves and they you know change their ways. They give us commitments. They then go stop all these things. And we they realize even yesterday they said there is six people down before last week, 9 people the week before that. And I think today itself, we they hear say we don't collect maybe nearly the last victims of kidnap from these bandits. The last victims have been released from those gunmen.
So you believe say with this one now the problem will finish?
You go finish now because then to get problem now and then get complaints.
Who so if there's
this you know say not only people when they look this thing that's in north and south, not true. Look, this problem between herdsmen and farmers, not be only between north and south. For northern Nigeria, over 100 years this problem they happen between farmers and herdsmen. And this the problem can't they play a role inside this kind of wahala. People, and the agreement we say they no go they attack Fulani people anymore anywhere, even in northern Nigeria. They no go attack for Sokoto and Zamfara. The agreement we say Fulani when enter markets for villages in Sokoto and Zamfara, they no go attack them, they no go harass them, they no go molest them. That's part of the agreement. And these bandits now, then to them promise say they no go carry gun again, they no go kidnap people again, they no go attack villages again. And for over 1 week now, we don't realize, we don't see peace in villages. People were drawn from their village, come local government headquarters or so, you know. And then they return now. They return, go back to their villages. So I think a lot of success, we they realize a lot of success for this part of Nigeria over because of dialogue and so on.
So far now, if anybody want to come there now, wahala not there at all.
You know, go experience wahala. And because the thing they improve now, and every day now, you know, say this is a slow process now. Nobody, something will happen overnight, but we don't realize success and improvement in security situation.
But it gets any of the community where they'll say people don't rock come out because of this bandit before?
Yeah, now, we get now.
Like,
get now.
What will be the name of the area?
Like, come, like in Isa, local government. Villages in Isa local government, villages in Sabon Birni local government, villages in Goronyo local government. These are villages where they get the same boundary which is Zamfara State. You know, then they sack villages, people they fear and they run, leave their village. But now people they go back, they need to go back now.
So if we say we won't even go to those area now, may we not fear to come?
Make you no fear, but I go advise say if you want to come, Mokuna come Sokoto first too. Mokuna deal with authorities. At least they will give you some cover or security. Ordinarily in Nigeria, you know, go not be any village you go everywhere, any part of the country, you go just enter any village like that. Now.
You know, for this side, anywhere we just enter.
But even for there now, they need to do kidnapping for there.
Now express they take over here. Benin to Lagos now no go area.
So you see now. So if you want to go Benin to Lagos, any village, you go get security now, she?
I think the Commissioner of Police for Edo and the IG, they don't call the deal with the situation to make sure, say, all those kidnappers away the express road, to make sure say they catch and drive them come out.
That was a good news, but even for here, good news day for this part of the country now. Improvement, they see improvement and the sensitivity they work.
Okay, we salute you when it's time to join us this evening from Sokoto State.
Thank you very much.
Help us greet our governor there. Say we they greet him from Edo.
I go greet him for now.
And greet thanks. Everybody so for Sokoto.
Thank you.
Well, I think right. Yes, you see the time when we say we don't take the, we don't go Taraba, we go Sokoto, we go Zamfara.
Yes.
To really go know the situation report for those areas. Okay. And so far, I think there's improvement compared to where we from they come.
Well, the improvement did, but I believe say, the governors for this other side too, may they also brace up for the challenge. I go also beg our people, particularly our traditional rulers, all those theories and all of them. They get big role to play because the information of the year, you know, they sweet that most of them, they don't collect rent, collect money for, collect car from some of these people. So when they call it, all these things happen, they don't know where they go. Because we want to know who they do this killing. We want to know who they do this kidnapping. How I go there for instance, say I come from a kind of north. People go build a camp for around my village, I don't know. I'll say I come from somewhere in Urumi. People go build a camp for Urumi village, I don't know, and I'll do inside. I will come from somewhere like maybe Iguye or Olubu. Other people go build camp for inside our village, I wouldn't know. We're supposed to, not be, at least as the world they grow, normally the way they live olden days, like if you try this security now. Not the way they fight security before that time, not the way they fight now. So the way our parents were living in the olden days is different. We cannot just keep quiet and hey, we like everybody. We like everybody. No. And even to the traditional rulers, most of those are in general, we also beg them. Make them stop all these things because something when you know that you go do. And at the end of the day, you can't then endure to the people who say you they govern. And a generation of born. For instance, you collect car, and at the end of the day, that car when you collect now, say do some kind of thing, you can't make people when we say you they rule govern. They suffer. How you going to do that kind of thing?
Well, I think as we they talk, our brother Bernard will be the PD, don't they tell us say all the time we don't they chop our time since. So maybe we'll wrap up the program. We don't say if we say mostly continue time not go permit us. So yes. Because of that, we must obey the rule of the game. Yes, so the time we Bernard get for us, we say don't reach.
All right, no problem. With a lot of other people we say join us for this program. Time not permit us. We'll also say we'll also reach Yobe State and the other states of this country. But maybe by another SP, we'll reach Yobe, we'll also reach Benue, just to tell us, maybe also to carry everybody along for inside this program, how this program tell you what
well, well, you were there since we salute to now, we'll be so now today watching. So that may just see a different security report from different friends states, so that you will know what you go through they do for the area where we'll be so today. God will bless you now. See you now on Friday.
On Friday don't
forget
yes.
This segment, just monitor by Thursday for our terrestrial transmission by 4:30 to 5:30. This edition again, you go feel wash your bet on Friday. We'll see they come your way again.